Take a look now at the idea of the law of large numbers. The law of large numbers simply says that as the number of times that experiments repeated, like tossing a coin, increases as you toss that coin more and more and more, the value of the empirical probability, remember the empirical probability is what you get from the experiment when you actually do an experiment, will approach the value of the theoretical. And if you recall, the theoretical probability is the true probability. Now mathematically, we would simply write that, we write that p hat, the empirical probability, approaches an arrow, means it goes to p, the true probability. Okay, because we use a hat for empirical probability. Let's take a look at the idea of how this would happen or be applied to like tossing a single coin. If you toss a single coin, say 10 times, in theory you should get 5 heads and 5 tails. In practice, that probably wouldn't happen all that often. It would happen, but not all that often. So perhaps you did it and you got, say 6 out of 10. Well, without any other knowledge, you'd say, well, my best estimate for the probability of getting a head, if you flip a single coin, is 6 out of 10, a little bit better than a half. You're only off by 1, right? It should have been 5 out of 10. You're off by 1, but it's still 10% off. It's quite a bit. So now let's say you flip it 100 times, and you're still off by 1. Well, being off by 1 now means you had 51 out of 100. Well, now you're only 1%, went from 10% off down to 1%, but you're still only off 1. Now, that doesn't mean if you flip a coin 100 times, you actually get 51. Realistically, anywhere between like 45 and 55 wouldn't surprise me at all. But what happens as n increases, the number of times you do this increases, this denominator gets bigger and bigger and bigger, and if I'm only off by a couple, the effect that a couple has on those bigger and bigger trials gets smaller and smaller and smaller. So this is getting closer and closer to a half. If you did it in a calculator, which quite frankly I think your calculator would probably roll over and die, but if you tried to take your calculator and do it like 10,000 times, yeah, I'm sure your calculator would have a heart attack on that one. It wouldn't bear to handle it. But if you did like a computer, you simulate with zeros and ones, random numbers, 10,000 times, you'd probably be at like 0.50001 or 0.4999 or something like that. Very, very, very close to one half. That's the idea of law of large numbers. It says that as we increase the number of times that we do an experiment, the empirical probability gets closer and closer and closer to that theoretical probability, the true probability of an event.